cold weather. Woo. It does look cold with what I'm wearing, but it's like 15 degrees out Fahrenheit and everything is just not happening. We're getting there though. At least that's running, which means it's charging this thing, which means I'm gonna eventually get this thing started. Here's how we're sitting. Pretty sure what's going on. I think the starter's going bad on it. I think it's just drawing so hard, it just can't crank that engine over. I mean, it's and we have jumper cables. I checked the voltage of the batteries. Everything's good. Connection to the battery. I've ran the jumper cables directly to the starter on the positive and the ground on the starter. Still no change. So that means I gotta get this truck disconnected. So I'm gonna try to get the front end loader started. I'm gonna hook onto this thing. Disconnect the trailer, drop the stands down, and drag the truck out of here. Then I'm gonna bring the loader in, lift up the back of the trailer, and try to basically walk this thing into the shop for a reason, which I haven't told you guys yet. You'll see. Well, let's try to get this done. Well, because this thing hasn't started in a while, there we go, and everything is icy cold, I'm gonna go ahead and throw the jumper cables on there before I even attempt to crank it. Because I got this tractor all warmed up, and it's got easy battery access, so now'd be a great time to just throw one more set of insurance on this thing to try to get this one started. My battery cutoff exploded internally. Fried. Just took too much trying to crank this thing. Too many amps. So I'm taking leads off this battery disconnect and I'm gonna hook them together and then crank it. And then when I'm done with this thing, I'm just gonna disconnect that and leave it disconnected, and that'll be our new battery disconnect until we get a new one. All right, let's try it again. It's bound to work now. I know I got good battery juice, this thing. So do I have power inside here? Turn the key on. No, I don't. Oh, there we go. Yep, got power. We'll try it without starting fluid. I think I got enough in there. Yes. Yes, that's what I'm talking about. All right, let this warm up. I'm gonna go park that tractor. Oh, my fingers are so cold and my dislocated middle finger is very much hurting right now. Okay. Well, this jump pack works like a charm. But the thing is, it only works as good as the starter. And the starter on that truck is junk. So I'm pretty sure it's junk. It's gotta be. It's been giving us trouble for a while now. And we've redid all the wiring on that thing from the grounds to lead. It's got three batteries on it. They all have good voltage. Yeah, it's gotta be a starter. Oh, warm those hands up. Oh, I got weak hands. Whew. Didn't put my warmer gear on. I got some refrigerator gear out over here. I might throw that on. It is cold. You'll see why I need that in a second. Now this is warmed up. Let's button up the doors. Drive it over that truck. Oh yeah, finally some real gloves. Yeah, those are nice. Come on, girl. Let's go. You can do it. Look at that fancy hitch. Well, that's convenient. Except for I don't have enough chain. I gotta back this thing up further. Okay, now unhook the truck. Let's crank on this a little bit. You guys remember this thing? I'll show you what that's for. Slight change of plans. Got a ratchet strap instead, so I'm just ratcheting. So what I'm trying to do now is I'm trying to unhook the fifth wheel plate from the fifth wheel. Fortunately, I've got a truck right here, so I can attach the ratchet strap to that, tighten it up, which hopefully pulls a pin. We'll reef on this a little bit. That's tight. Let's see here, how are we sitting? That's loose. I'm sure there needs to be slack on this. I don't know if I can get this to come apart. Help this truck drive it. Okay, just about got it. Crank it a few more times. Okay, I think it's released. I'm gonna slowly pull this truck, see if we can get it separate. I think I've got that pin disengaged, so fifth wheel should be unlocked. If not, it's hanging on by just a little bit, but I can't get the budget anymore, so I'm gonna attempt to pull the truck. We'll see if we can get it to move. We'll be right back. It's in the shop. I still haven't told you guys why we brought this in here in the first place for. You'll see, soon enough. Just a minute. All right, we're back in the shop and it is getting warm in here. Fortunately, that spray trailer is warming up. You guys saw all the fun I had getting that thing out of the cold. I just love winter. Winter's great. But here's why it's here. We've got Doug from Praxidine.
Hi.
And Doug makes the Mixmate. If you guys have ever heard of the Mixmate, it's basically a smart way of mixing your products on the sprayer. What would be like the best way to put it in like simple man's terms?
Push the easy button.
So you pull up, push the easy button.
And away you go.
And away you go. I like that. So mixing multiple batches of chemicals, water levels, all kinds of things, this will take care of that.
Absolutely.
That sounds like a deal. I'm ready for this. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna install this on our spray trailer and get rid of our mutant mixing setup that we have right now. But this is gonna be so much nicer. This is basically a very, very simple version of what the Mixmate is over there. And if you guys remember, I had taken parts from an old sprayer of ours, an old X67 flex coil wheel boom sprayer, I think that's what it was. Some stuff off a Big Root, some of the parts that we didn't use on that sprayer, we took that apart. We got a handler too with the Venturi and a meter and all kinds of stuff. And the idea between this thing is basically I can have 3 to 4 shuttles on this drop deck and then meter the chemicals by hand with these valves through this meter into the sprayer. Well, that Mixmate's gonna do all that for me. We are gonna start disassembling the handler too with my crazy mutant setup on here to get ready to put that Mixmate up here. What we gotta do is figure out is all the plumbing we need to make this happen. So when this is off and everything's disassembled, we're gonna plop the Mixmate down and start kind of basically sketching up a plan of what kind of fitting valves, hoses we need to make this thing happen. Yeah. So we tore off the old handler, pretty easy. Now we got the Mixmate on and we're just kind of playing makeshift, seeing what we think is the best location for this unit. Because wherever this thing goes down is where everything else is gonna tie into it. So this is kind of the first step getting this figured out. So we're just gonna keep moving this around in circles until we finally find a spot we think it fits.
Yeah.
And everyone goes, I like it. All right, we're making progress. I think we've got a game plan figured out. We're gonna change kind of the way we had it the first time. I don't go up here very often, but this is just some storage that we have in the back area. I think I'm gonna haul these down. These are lots of random fittings we have and might use a few of these. So I might as well just get them down there. That way we can have them on site and start piecing out what we need. Put a parts list together. Then we gotta make a trip to go get a bunch of fittings. Hey everybody, welcome back. And guess what? I've got my pickup hooked up to the gooseneck and I am gonna go on a little trip somewhere to pick up something really special that you guys are definitely, I don't have a clue what it's gonna be because it's a little unusual. And I've got plans for this thing and I hope you guys tag along and enjoy this.
There's lights on the cars.
There was lights on the cars?
Yeah.
Really? Was there a truck?
Yeah.
There was? Carl's wash car?
Yeah.
Carl's car wash.
Oh.
Oh boy, they want to go to the car wash.
Well, we're in the process of Christmas shopping is what he said, you know, and someone made a comment that somebody must have been bad.
Because we're buying pipe fittings for Christmas.
I'm buying fitting for Christmas. It's kind of the color of coal.
Yeah, it is. It kind of does look like coal.
Well, I don't know if I feel dreamy, but it might be a pipe dream.
So, there you go.
Yeah, that's right. It's fitting for us.
The guy's got all the parts lined up here. So I think it's time to start assembling this thing. So Dad's already working on the main valve coming off the pump. I'm gonna find a place to fit in here too and get to work. So let's go. Well, those guys are getting close to getting it all buttoned up, ready to fire up. He wants to run it before he takes off, just to make sure we're good. Run all the valves, make sure everything turns on and off. So I gotta get some water, because, well, we don't really have that kind of volume of water sitting at the shop like that. So I'm gonna go get the other water truck that was winterized. We'll get her fired up. Let's hope it starts better than the first one did. Get a load of water, go in there, we'll park in the shop, we'll cross fill back into one of those yellow or green tanks, and then hopefully it'll be ready here real soon. Fire the system up and run some fluids around, and should be good to deal. It's gonna be fun. I'm excited about the system. Dad and Doug have been going hard at it. I've been kind of sitting back going, well, what do I do? So this is my job, get water. That girl. I had it going. All right, I'm dumping gas in the carburetor. You guys aren't seeing me do that, but I am. Because it loses its prime for some reason, and then you gotta get to get fuel primed back through. But anyways, that's what I'm doing. There we go. Now she's rolling. Are we full yet? Half full maybe. I don't know how much water we need. Probably not this much. I'd say that's enough. Let's take this back to the shop, fill the other truck up, and go.
Please start, please start, please start. Yes, 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 yes.
No! Nope, we're good. Yes, there we go.
Oh, it's cold in here, and it's winter, and I didn't dress up for that.
Yep.
Dummy alert. That's okay. Just 2 miles back in the warm shop.
All right, we're getting pretty close to firing this up. We just grabbed an old shuttle that we had, the top cut off it, we're gonna put it up here as a chemical shuttle. It's gonna basically our product that we're gonna pull from. And so it's just gonna have water in it, so we're gonna fill it up, and then we'll test and show how it pulls the product from this into the MixMate, into the whole system. And you can see we've got a second pump here. This is a lot smaller pump. It's not a 3-inch pump. The purpose of this pump is to just run clean water through the whole system. So when you're changing out shuttles, purging, whatever it may be, that pump's gonna pressurize and wash the system out. So far, so good. They've just about got her plumbed. And we got water in this tank right up to here, so about 700 gallons. And I have a little bit left in this one too, so we should be plenty there. Quite a painstaking process of us drinking lots of coffee, talking a bunch, and then once in a while turning a wrench. The MixMate is on, and it's all plumbed behind us, as you can see back here. And we're set up for a demo run. We've got one shuttle of water, two tanks of water, and we're gonna run the system and pretend that we're actually doing a mix for a sprayer.
So this is a great way to learn how, you know, run some practice mixes. I got my Welker Farm shirt on, so it looks like, you know, I know what I'm doing here, and away we go.
Let's do it.
Oh, here, look at this.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, we've switched roles.
All right, so we've got the MixMate fired up. We've got this tablet fired up. The software that you guys have created runs through an app on Android tablets or Android software.
Mm-hmm.
So, and we've already gone and put in all of our prescriptions.
Right, put prescription product in, kind of got the basic setup for doing just some test run here. We've only got one tote connected right now because we ran out of pipe fittings.
Supply issue.
Yes.
But that's okay, because we're gonna get those soon. But that's fine, that'll be enough for us to show how this works, pulling from our potential glyphosate product over here through the stack.
Yep. Of valves over there. We'll show you how you use the jug in the inductor as well. We're gonna do a quick little demo here so you can see how it works. We've set up a prescription and job ahead of time. So basically, we can go in here, we select our job, it preloads the app with all the pertinent information. Next screen shows everything going in. So we've got water, Hellfire, which is a surfactant, and some glyphosate. Glyphosate's gonna come out of this tote over here. The Hellfire's gonna come through the inductor, and we'll do some jugs here. So I'm gonna hit the start button. We'll get in there and we'll have to get these pumps started.
Now he's got the product in. Now is it pumping out of this one yet?
That's already done.
just been in.
All right. So, can we look at the report and see what we did here?
Sure. This is a summary section, and then there's a report for each batch that's been made.
So for some reason something went wrong, we need to go back. We can see what did we put in there.
Exactly.
Now we gotta wait several months before we can actually use this thing, because it's winter.
Oh, bummer.
Yeah, that's okay. I'll find a reason. I'll sneak in here and do some runs.
Make a skating rink.
Yeah, that's
I'm trying to skate on thin ice anyway.
There you go.
So the cool part about this product, MixMate, is Doug here is a farmer like a lot of you guys, like us, and him and his boys designed the system.
Yeah, so our sons are ag engineers. They did a lot of projects as they were growing up in 4-H and FFA. Got their engineering degrees, worked at Kinsey and Kloss and Kuhn, and came back to the farm and build things and start a manufacturing company. So that's how MixMate got started.
So you guys know, he's got a lot of skin in the game. And this, I mean, they farm, they crop corn and beans back
exactly.
In Iowa, correct?
Yes, yeah.
So, I mean, they're there, they know. And the reason they built the system is because they saw a need.
Right, so this is something that I wanted on our farm probably 25 years ago, but we didn't have the expertise at the time to build it. And, you know, as Brent and Luke were growing up, they built all kinds of things, computerizing and welding and tons of stuff. We just loved to build those things on our farm. One of the things coming up along Welker Farms and Cole the Corn Star have influenced us as well. So we're going to be starting our own YouTube channel for our farm. And we're going to show a lot of these odd and end projects that we do. So there's one of the things actually related to MixMate. We're going to have a little, we're going to be running a test so that we can actually control the pump motor. So start these gas engines with the MixMate and shut them off. And we'll be doing that. We're going to do things like how we do our soil testing, developing our zones, because I think it's pretty unusual compared to what a lot of people do. But a lot of things that we build. So, you know, like truck and trailer builds for MixMates. Like Brent has done a solar panel array. He's going off grid on his house. And there's just all kinds of fun stuff we do. We're going to show you how to do it. And we're going to show you the parts and things. So if it's something you want to do, we'll help you get started through these videos.
And what's the name of the channel?
Inventive Farmer.
Inventive Farmer. Cool.
So
I'll be looking forward to it.
Yeah, it'll be coming online soon.
Well, that's cool. We need a channel like that, because technology and farming is ever entwining, and you guys are at the leading edge of making that happen.
Sometimes bleeding edge.
Bleeding edge. Bleeding, yeah. Money and blood.
Right, exactly.
These guys are thinking ahead and showing that it can be done. You don't have to necessarily rely on,
right,
on
right.
someone who doesn't even step on the farm to figure it out for you. He's an actual farmer. So cool, Doug. Well, thank you. Appreciate your time being here and helping set this up. And spray season can't come soon enough, I guess, right?
Amen.
Okay. All right, guys. Take care. God bless and have a wonderful day. And I hope you think about MixMate, because I am.